such enemies often do. In the seemingly most innocent and unlikely of places.
Look! I got misfit employees, bums on the sidewalk, business is lousy, my life is a living hell. You urchins, off the stoop. It ain't bad enough I got the winos permanently decorating the storefront. I need 5 words this ragamuffins to complete the picture.
Oh, we bothering nobody, are we, Crystal?
No, we're not, Ronette.
You ought to be in school.
We're on a split shift.
Right. We went to school to the 5th grade, then we split.
Well, how do you intend to better yourselves?
Better ourselves. Mister, when you're from Skid Row, ain't no such thing.
Downtown, 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 down
I guess this is it. Don't bother coming in tomorrow.
You don't mean!
You can't mean!
What? What don't I mean? I mean I'm closed! Forget it! Kaput!
You can't!
Kaput! Extinct! I'm closing this garden customer-forsaken place!
Mr. Mushnick, excuse me for saying so, but has it ever occurred to you that, well, maybe you'll defer needs us to move in a new direction?
What he was trying to say, Mr. Mushnick, is, well, we've talked about it, and we both agree. Seymour, why don't you run it back and get that strange and interesting new plant you've been working on? You see, Mr. Mushnick, some of the exotic plants Seymour has been tinkering around with are really unusual, and we were thinking with some of his strange and interesting plants, prominently displayed and advertised, would attract business?
I'm afraid it isn't feeling very well today.
Yeah. Now, isn't that bizarre?
At least. What kind of weirdo plant is that, Seymour?
I don't know. It looks like some kind of fly trap, but I haven't been able to identify many of my books. So, I gave it my own name. I call it Minology 2.
After me?
I hope you don't mind. You see, sir, if you put a strange and interesting plant like this here in the window, maybe.
Maybe what? Do you have any idea how ridiculous you sound? Just because you put a strange and interesting plant in a window, people don't suddenly—
Excuse me! I couldn't help noticing that strange, interesting plant. What is it?
It's an odd thing too!
I've never seen anything like it before.
No one has.
Where'd you get it?
Well, you remember that total eclipse of the sun a few weeks ago? I was walking in the wholesale flower district that day. And I passed by this place, this old Chinese man.
He
sometimes sells me weird and exotic cuttings.
Because
he knows strange plants are my hobby. He had nothing unusual there that day. And I was about to, walk on by. When suddenly, through that warning, there was this
total eclipse of the sun.
It got very dark, and I heard this strange humming sound like something from another world. And when light came back, this weird plant was just sitting there. Stuck in, among the zinnias. I could have sworn it hadn't been there before. The old Chinese man sold it to me anyway.
Wow, that's an unusual story. A fascinating plan. Oh, I may as well take $50 worth of roses while I'm here.
$50?
$50?
Yes, sir, right away, sir!
Can you break 100?
100? No, I'm afraid to close the register for the day.
Well, I'll just have to take twice as many, won't I?
Twice as many?
Twice as many?
Twice as many? $100 worth. Yes, sir, right away, sir! Audrey, my darling, kindly fetch this gentleman $100 worth of our very finest red American beauty roses.
Thank you very much.
Yes, sir, that is one strange, interesting plant.
Oh, no, just say that. Quick, put that plant up. What do you call it?
An Audrey 2.
Well, put that Audrey 2 in the window so passers-by can see. My God, I never believe it. My children. I'm taking us all to dinner!
So, I'd love to, Mr. Mushnick, but I've got a date!
With that same no good, Nick? Audrey, I'm telling you, you don't need a date with him. You need major medical. He ain't a good, clean kind of boy.
He's a professional.
What kind of professional drives a motorcycle or wears a black leather jacket.
He's a rebel, Mr. Mushnick, but he makes some money. And besides, he's the only fellow I've got. Well, you two enjoy dinner. Good night, Seymour.
Good night. Poor girl. Are we still going to dinner?
You're not going anywhere, Krell boy. You're staying right here and taking care of this sick plant. How come it's fading all the time?
I told you it's been giving me trouble. It just wilts like this. The Audrey 2 is not a healthy girl.
Strictly between us, neither is the Audrey 1.
If only you knew what species it is, but what genus? There's nowhere in the books.
Well, Krellborn, my advice is you figure it out,
and fast. Look what this exotic beauty did for business.
I know.
So work, Seymour. Nurse that little plant back to help.
I'm counting on you.
I know.
You do?
I do.
So fix. Good night.
You sickly little plant, or are you just plain stubborn? What is it you want? What is it you need? I've given you sunshine, I've given you dirt. You've given me nothing but heartache and hurt. I'm begging you sweetly, I'm down on my knees. Oh, please grow for me. I've given you plant food. I've given you pot ash, you've given me zip. Oh gosh, how I missed you. Oh pot, how you tease. Now please go for me. I've given you southern exposure to get you to thrive. I've sent you back hard like I'm supposed to. You're barely alive. I've tried to move levels of moisture from desert to mud. I've given you gold like some mineral supplements. What do you want from me? What?
Ouch!
Darn roses? Darn thorns? Clumsy me. Look what I did, Tui. Hey, you're open gum. What made you do that?
Do you mind if I call you genius?
Gosh, no.
The genius who has developed a new breed of plant life hitherto unknown on this planet.
The Audrey 2.
Oh, one last question, Mr. Crowmore. Do you feed it anything special?
Special? No.
It's a secret formula, but it's not hard to come by. I see. Well, thanks for driving by, and
I'd like to remind our listeners of the Audrey 2 cosplay exclusively of Mushley Cedro Forest.
Oh, thank you.
Over 6 days away from Denny,
aka the address, Much of the.
Oh, well. It's still great advertising.
Remarkable things that people, they do.
Simple network of odd mods by midday, so they ride on me to drive them nuts. What a blessing this wonderful plan should exist and to break in the box with me hand over fast.
Well, how they do?
Oh, you were great, Seymour. You sounded sexier than a wolf, man.
But you didn't mention the address of the shop. How many times have I come to
you? I'm sorry, I was nervous. Where's Audrey? She said she'd be here.
Forget about Audrey. I've already got three more radio interviews lined for tomorrow. And the Skid Row Herald exam now wants a picture.
If I had a mother, she'd be so happy.
You're an overnight sensation, Seymour. Who'd have believed it?
One day he pushed up.
But he sure is hazardous to your health.
Well, That's for sure. But I can't leave him.
And why not?
Well, he would get angry. And if he does this to me when he likes me, imagine what he'd do if he ever got mad.
So dump the chump, get another guy, and let him protect you.
And we got one all picked out.
A little botanical genius.
And she ain't talking about George Washington Carver.
Seymour?
Bingo.
Oh, we're just friends. Besides, I could never be Seymour's girl. I've got a pass.
And who amongst us has not?
I don't deserve a sweet, considerate, suddenly successful guy like Seymour.
This girl suffers from low self-image.
You have a point.
She have a problem.
I know Seymour's the greatest, but I'm dating a sexist, so I cut a black eye.
An emergency room?
No, it's just a daydream of mine. A little development I dream of just off the interstate. Not fancy like Levittown. Just a little street in a little suburb, far, far from urban Skid Row. The sweetest, greenest place where all the houses have the same little lawn out front and the same little flags on patio out back. And all the houses are so neat and pretty, because they all look just alike. Oh, I dream about it all the time. Just me, and the toaster, and a sweet little guy, like Seymour. A matchbox of arms, a fence of real.
Thank you.
cleaning up and brooming, cause customers are flocking, and this has been booming. We need refrigeration in our new improved display, so we're close to renovation to grow.
Yes, indeed, this is the flower shop you heard on Channel 5. Yes, the Audrey 2 is on display exclusively here.
What's for decoration?
I'm doing my best, but all these paintings make it kind of hard.
You've been getting hurt so much lately!
I know! Seems like every time I think of a pruning shears, I slip!
Did you get that order out for Mrs. Shiva?
Mrs. Shiva?
Mrs. Shiva!
Mrs. Shiva. I forgot.
One moment, please.
Oh, no.
You forgot. You forgot! How could you put an order like that? The Shivas are our most important funeral account! A big, enormous family dropping off like flies! I'm telling you, Crown One, if we lose business over this, you are finished!
Boy.
Hey, Seymour!
You know, I think Mr. Wisnik is way too hard on you.
Oh, I don't mind. After all, I owe him everything. He took me out of Skidrow's home for boys when I was just a little tight. Gave me a warm place to sleep, and under the counter. Nice things to eat, like meatloaf and water. Floors to sweep, and toilets to clean, and every other Sunday off.
You know, I think you ought to raise your expectations, Seymour. Well, I mean, now that we're getting all successful, why don't you start with some new clothes? Well, no offense, but with all the interviews and photo sessions, a big, important, experimental botanist has to look the part.
I'm a very bad shopper, Audrey. I don't have good taste. Like you do.
Well, I could help you pick things out.
You could?
Sure.
You would go shopping with me?
Sure.
You would be seen in a public place with me. Like a department store?
Sure.
Tonight?
I can't tonight. I've got a date. But I would love to go with you another time.
Sure. I'll pencil you in.
I bet you've got a lot of dates now, huh?
Well, not dates exactly, but a lot of gardening clubs have been calling, asking me to give lectures.
Well.
Imagine me giving lectures. I never even finished grade school.
Oh, that doesn't matter. You've got life experience.
Some experience. I don't even know what it's like to find an airplane.
Oh, well, me neither.
Or eat a fancy dinner at Howard Johnson's.
Oh, me neither.
Or ride a motorcycle.
Oh, it's no big deal. Besides, it's dangerous.
It is?
extremely dangerous. Gee, I better go fix my face. My things will be here any minute.
Excuse me, ladies. Which way to 935 Skid Row?
I'm afraid that information will cost you a dollar.
Hey, no problem. Here you go.
It's right over there. But if you're like the thousands of others flocking down to see the Audrey 2, you better come back tomorrow, man. This shop is closed today. Ooh, took his dollar.
I'm not here to buy posies, girls. I'm here to pick up my date.
Your date?
You ain't by any chance talking about a girl with a black eye
and several other medical problems?
As a matter of fact.
That's it! I can't wait for you!
Ladies, please. I'm friendly. Truce. Peace. You want some nitrous oxide?
Why don't you get lost, Vitalis Brains? The last thing Audrey needs is more of your kind.
My kind is a very nice kind. I'm not a monster.
What else would you call it?
I would call it a... I would call it an occupational hazard.
Say what?
You see, girls, my line of work requires a... a certain fascination in the human pain and suffering.
Yes! Yes!
Ma'am, this stuff is great! Allow me to explain. When I was younger, just a bad little kid, my mama noticed funny things I did. Like shooting puppies with a BB gun. I poisoned guppies, and when I was done, find a pussycat and bash in his head. That's what my mama said.
What did she say?
She said, my boy, I think someday you'll find a way to make your natural tendencies pay. You'll be her death and
death.
Have a talent for causing things pain.
Hey!
Son, be your death and
death.
People will pay. Your temperament's on the bracelet and teach you what to choose the less. So be her death and death. You'll be her success.
Serious girls, the leader of the class. Watch you suck up that gas. Oh my god! What? That's the best I'll never be.
Say ah.
Ah.
Say ah.
clothes.
I'm not here to shop. I'm here to... Hey, this must be that plant they're talking about on the news.
What do you call it?
An Audrey 2?
Oh, good thing. Sketch. Nice place.
Babe.
Thank you. I raised myself. Now,
I heard it's some kind of new species or something.
That's what they told me, but you'll have to leave now.
I'll tell you something, guy. You say you raised this thing, right, Trey? Well, if I were you, I most certainly would not keep it under a barrel in a skid row dumb place like this. This avocado here could be your ticket to the stars. You could take this to any florist in town and name your price. Somebody would make you their partner just to get their hands on this.
I can. I'm happy here.
Seymour is very loyal.
Somebody talking to you?
Excuse me.
Excuse me? What?
Excuse me, doctor.
That's better. I'll tell you, kid. Get yourself out of this dump and take the plants with you.
What?
Mushnik's Skid Row florists? It's like a joke. You hear me talking?
I do.
Shouldn't we be going now? I'm sorry.
Sorry? What?
Doctor, sorry, doctor.
You gotta train him, eh, stud? Well, my bike's outside and double parked. But you think about what I said. I mean, you think about it.
Sure. Sure, I'll think about it.
You'll think about it?
You do that.
Okay, Audrey.
You got the handcuffs?
There, right in my bag.
Then let's go.
You'll think about it. You'll think about it.
I'm like that guy in Smushnik. You should hear the way he talks to Audrey.
Got them himmel nubbix, they just sent me mullet over.
No wonder she looks so unhelpful. It's enough to make you sick.
If he left me, if Seymour left me, why then I'd be right back where I started with us. Broken star.
Sweet and good and beautiful as she is, she deserves a prince not to this and treat like him.
Closer bankrupt.
What a louse.
He said be fuddled and bereft. That's what I mean, Seymour left.
He's disgraced and dead of confession.
Seymour!
Seymour. How would you like to be my son? My own adopted boy. I never liked him much before. Count the questions in the drawer. Got no choice unless you both say yes. Seymour, I want to be your dad. I want to see you climbing up my family tree. I used to think you left a stench, but now I see that you remain. So I'm proposing be my son. More spirit and soul. Sounds great. My son, just say the word, I'll have my lawyer on the phone.
Now, Mr. Mushnik, don't be rash. Always said that I was trash.
Oh, I was joking.
Sure, I'm joking.
Use a physical expression of my pride, of the sweet paternal Michigas I've held pent up inside. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Will hold my breath until...
To keep on feeding you. To kill people?
I'll make it worth your while.
What?
You think this is all coincidence, baby? The sudden success around here? Your adoption papers?
Look, your plants, an inanimate object!
Does this look an enemy to you, punk? If I can talk, now I can move. Who say I can do anything I want?
Like what?
Like deliver, pal. Like you get anything your secret, greasy heart desires. Would you like a Cadillac car? Or get your arm jackpot? I want a date with Hedy Lamar, you little
daddy.
How'd you like to be a big wheel? Dining out for every meal. I'm a plant, can't make it a wheel, you get it.
You're gonna get it.
You know the kind of heat, the kind of red hot juice, the kind of sticky lickies which I crave. Come on, see boy, don't be a fuss. Trust me in the life, until they rob me, cuss. Sure that I'll next year, we're gonna be good.
I don't know.
Come on, kid, what'll it be? Money? Girls? One particular girl?
How about
Audrey? Think it over. There must be someone you can hate his ex really well like and get me some lunch.
At
the bottom, we're in the mix. Wrapped in velvet, diamond, and glitz. A little nook, you gotta pay your tits.
Get it, get it.
No, I don't know anyone who deserves to get chopped up and fed to a hungry plant.
Sure you do.
Stupid woman! What a scalper!
I'm sorry, Doctor, I'm sorry!
Now get in there and bam, you're friggin' sweating!
Yes, I can't hurry my doctor! I see you,
I'm not sweating anymore! Come on, Lord, you idiot! How you like that stupid thing? Get some friggin' sweater, you idiot! And go ahead and slow down!
Gone.
right?
So why are you pointing a gun at me, Seymour?
I
feel a little nervous about seeing a dentist.
No, not nervous.
It's only gonna hurt a little.
No, you don't understand. I don't want my teeth examined.
Of course you want your teeth examined. Say ah.
No.
Say ah.
Ooh.
Your mouth is a mess, kid. You've got cavities. You've got black. You're impacted. You're abscessed.
I am?
You're going to need a complete oral examination. We'll start with that wisdom tooth.
No.
We'll just rip that bugger right out of there.
What is that?
I gotta go. There's always time for dental hygiene, Seymour. Have you seen the results of a neglected mouth? Look at this. This could happen to you.
It could?
Unless I take immediate action. Let's get started.
Wait, aren't you gonna give me Novocaine?
What for? Dulls the senses.
But it'll hurt.
Only till you pass out.
What's that?
That's the drill, Seymour.
It's rusty.
It's an antique. They don't make instruments like this anymore. Heavy. Sturdy. Dull. This is going to be a challenge. This is going to be a pleasure! I'm gonna want some gas for this one.
Gas?
Nitrous oxide.
Thank God. But you won't even use any.
Oh no! The gas isn't for you, Seymour. It's for me. You see, I really want to enjoy this. And I find that a little giggle gas, before we begin, increases my pleasure enormously. In fact, I'm going to use my special gas mask. Just relax, Seymour. I'll be with you in a moment.
Palpable stupor, the times I feel in the moment is super to ready and fire. Lunatic took you away. Now, to now, just a flicker of fresh right here on the trigger. And I'll go and have to put up with that thing for another day. I'll just take the mask off now and... Hey, Seymour, guess what?
What?
It's stuck.
What?
The mask, it's stuck. I can't get it off. I could have asphyxiated in here.
Well,
he says, well, I don't think you understand, Seymour. Don't be fooled if I should giggle like a sappy, happy dope. It's just the gas.
Logic there, but we have years to go prompt to our health. The past will go like a mirror. The truth I tried.
staying in the chair.
Don't be fooled if I should kick like hyenas in a zoo. It's just a guess.
So McKenna, church, and I combine.
need to be there in the morning.
Outfits, not nice ones like this.
behind you now. You don't have anything to be ashamed of. You're a very nice person. I always knew you were. Underneath all the bruises and handcuffs, you know what I saw? A girl I respected. I still do. Lift up your head. Wash off your mascara. Here, take my Kleenex. Wipe that lipstick away. Show me your face, clean as the morning. I know things were bad, but now they're okay. Suddenly Seymour is standing beside you. You don't need no makeup.
Thank you.
all over the floor.
You're acting pretty strange, Pops.
I had a pretty strange day, son. After my lawyer's appointment, I was called to the police station.
The police?
Yes. It seems they made a pretty routine investigation into the disappearance of this motorcycle dentist. And when they did, it seems they found a Mushnik Skid Row florist bag in his office.
What's that supposed to mean?
Exactly what I asked myself, Seymour!
But then I began to think about certain things I've noticed around here lately. Little red dots all over the linoleum.
I spilled some Hawaiian punch and it stained.
It's hard to keep things clean around here, isn't it? Especially when they only remove our garbage once a month.
What does that have to do with... Where are you going?
If you want something removed in a hurry, it's best not dispose of it on Skid Row.
What are you talking about?
This! A dentist uniform!
He's got your number now.
I saw it last week and didn't think twice.
He knows just what you've done.
And the little red dot seemed innocent enough.
You've got no place to hide.
The man I kept kissing the dentist girl?
You've got nowhere to run.
And it begins to look like a motive.
He knows you're like a crime.
Once he's out of the way, you move it!
I think it's supper time.
I'm innocent! I'm innocent!
Then explain this!
Picture of a baseball cap?
Your baseball cap. The police found it in Scarbello's office. Showed it to me. Asked if I could identify it.
Did you?
No. They don't suspect you at all, Seymour. But they don't know about the dots, the uniform, the girl!
I didn't do it!
Come with me and tell them that.
He's got his back so straight.
Just so my conscience will rest easy.
You know he's on a trip.
If you don't, I'll have to go tell him myself.
He's gonna turn you in.
When you come,
they're gonna put you in jail. Supper time. Come on, speak about all those awkward words. Come on,
here, oh.
Come on, ain't no time to turn in the dish. Come on, spell on my
they so they can deposit them in the morning?
You put them in the safe, didn't you?
No.
Why not?
I forgot the combination.
It stops at the palace. Where is it?
It's in the plant.
In the plant?
I thought it'd be the safest place. You don't need to look in there, right?
The money's inside the plant. So how am I supposed to get it?
Just knock.
Seymour. From uptown. He's been asking all over where can he find you.
are you gonna be happy when you do? Seymour, sweetheart, tall face, oval eyes. Hey, Seymour, proud morning prince, you. My name is Bernstein, I'm with NBC. I came down here to convince you to do a weekly TV show for me. Seymour, Crowborn's got an egg tip. You like it? I love it. Half an hour on Sundays at 4. TV's first home gardening program. You'll make a mint and our ratings will soar.
Anymore. They say that
Lay off, Tui.
Can't you see I'm busy?
Too bad, Rob.
Give me a break. I've got to finish my speech for the lecture tour. It's all about you. Give me some peace and quiet, or I'll tell him the truth.
Don't get you with me. I made you, and I can break you.
Go ahead, break me.
Think it's easier to with the guilt?
Cut the crap and bring on the meat.
If only you would eat me. If only you would touch a mouse or flies. But no, you're so particular.
Come on, Gravel Boy. Feed me. I ate incense mushing, and that was a week ago.
Look, just hold out one more night, can you? That's all I ask. Life Magazine will be here in the morning to take our picture.
And then you'll find me somebody.
And you'll never go hungry again. I promise.
Chow time, Grellhorn! Food! 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 Feed me!
I can't take this anymore! Stop squalling!
You're trying to
eat
me!
Food! Shut up, Goya! Shut up! Shut up! Shut up!
Sam! What's the matter with you?
It's the matter with me! Don't you think I know that it needs food? Don't you think I know that if I don't feed it soon, it'll die? Don't you think I'm trying to think of some way, something or someone?
Zima! You're hysterical! What's the big deal about a little plant food? I think running this place all by yourself is too much for you. But what did Mushnik say to be back?
Huh?
You know, in that note you told me he left you, the one that said he was going to his sister's house in...
To Czechoslovakia.
Right. He could be gone a very long time. Audrey, could I ask you something?
Anything.
Well, let's suppose for a minute that there had never even been an Audrey 2. That... I was just nothing again. A nobody. Would you still like me?
I'd still love you, Seymour.
And it's settled.
What's settled? I've got it!
Hand bullets, hand wrap poison, hand machete! Tomorrow morning, right after Life Magazine takes our picture, you know who bites the dust.
Seymour!
They'll snap the photo. We'll be famous. We'll take that TV job. We'll live a nice, quiet, normal life together. No more night feedings. No more squalling for blood.
What? What? What feedings? What blood? I don't get it, Seymour. Bullets? Knives? Rat poison? You're kind of scaring me.
There isn't anything to be scared of. We'll go away from here. I'll take you to that little development you always dreamed about, and we'll be happy ever after. I promise. A nice little house, a nice little car,
and no plans. No plans at all.
Seymour, you're talking so peculiar.
I'll explain everything to you tomorrow. Just go home now, Audrey, please.
I can't leave you in this condition.
Don't worry about me.
Feed me!
Under no circumstances.
Feed me!
I will not, so stop asking.
Feed me!
I can't take much more of this. Look, I'll run down the corner, and I'll get you a pound of rare roast beef. Maybe that'll hold you till Life Magazine gets here.
No way.
Look, my last offer. Yes or no?
It's better than nothing.
Done. Fine. Great. Don't think you're getting dessert.
Sleep, sweetheart, tell me, tell me.
friendly Audrey too. This plant is talking to you.
I don't believe it.
Believe it, baby. It talks.
Am I dreaming this?
No, and you ain't in Kansas either.
Something is very wrong here.
Relax and go with it, doll. Do me a favor, will you, sweetheart?
A favor?
I need some water in the worst way. Look at my branches. I'm a god, honey. Come on and give me a drink.
I don't know if I should.
Hey, little lady, come on.
Is this the water, right?
Show you my
wings. Your friends are not
close to me. You know that.
Super time! Or relax, my little bitches! Come on, join your dentist friend and mush it there right inside!
No! Audrey! No! Get off of her! Get off of her!
Audrey, are you alright?
Thank you.
There he is, Mr. Martin. He's right in there.
Thanks, sweetheart. Wait for me. Crowborn? Seymour Crowborn?
Leave me alone.
Patrick Martin, Marketing and Licensing Division, World Botanical Enterprises. I've got a gilt-edged proposition for you, boy.
Not interested.
Let me explain more detail. It's a very simple licensing deal. We take leaf cuttings and develop little Audrey 2s and sell them to florists across the nation. Pretty soon, every household in America will have one. Well, I've got the truck waiting outside. It's a pot, and if you don't mind, we'll start taking clippings right now. Man, boy, Audrey 2's everywhere! Why, with the right advertising, this could become bigger than hula hoops!
Bigger than hula hoops.
Much bigger!
Every household in America, thousands of you, eating! That's what you had in mind all along, isn't it?
No kidding, Einstein!
We're not talking about one hungry plant here. We're talking about world conquest!
And I want to thank you!
You're a monster! So am I.
Feed me!
You ain't the only thing I ever loved!
Too bad!
Take that! And that! And that! And that! And that! And that!
Give up, cowboy!
Never! Here! That poison!
Eat that! It!
Give up, small fry!
Bite some tough on the outside! In there! In that pod! I'll hack you to bits! I'll get you from the inside! Mr. Crowborn? Mr. Crowborn? Okay, girls. All you have to do is sniff some of the smaller leaves and put them in these pots. I've got the truck waiting outside. Open up the van, boys. We're ready to start loading.
Subsequent to the events you have